Hey everybody, this is Brajesh here and you are watching your own channel CABA Infoventry. There is very good news for borrowers having loan up to rupees 2 crore that the difference between compound interest and simple interest on loan during moratorium period on 8 specified loans shall be credited to borrower's account on or before 5th November 2020. The 8 categories of borrowers who will be benefited from this decision of the central government was discussed by me in my earlier video, the link of which is given here. You may want that video by clicking this link. In this video, I shall be discussing with you the various submissions made by central government before Honorable Supreme Court in respect of crediting the compound interest charge during moratorium period by various lenders, which are very important for you as borrower to understand that whether you are entitled for this amount or not. Also, in second video on this issue, I shall be discussing your various queries and questions which may be coming to your mind in respect of this crediting the compound interest charge during moratorium period by various lenders in detail, so that you may understand whether this scheme will benefit you or not and how much benefit you will be getting as a borrower. Keep watching this video till end to take the full benefit on this issue. After months of litigation in the Honorable Supreme Court and a lot of confusion surrounding interest on interest being charged by the lenders on loan accounts whose payments were deferred under the moratorium scheme, Government of India has come out with the guidelines in line with the submissions made by it before Honorable Supreme Court. The plight of small borrowers has finally been addressed. Wide notification dated October 23, 2020, providing the scheme for grant of ex gratia payment of difference between compound interest and simple interest for 6 months to borrowers in loan accounts for the period from 1st March 2020 to 31st August 2020. This ex gratia payment scheme is another COVID-19 related relief and incentive by the central government to bear additional interest on interest on certain small specified loan accounts as a goodwill gesture towards the small borrowers. Ex gratia scheme is a sense of moral obligation rather than any legal requirement on the part of the government. The central government shall pay the difference between the compound interest and simple interest for 6 months period on loan accounts. That is the period commencing from March 1st, 2020 to August 31st, 2020, that is moratorium period. A scheme of waiver of interest on interest for eligible borrowers will be implemented by November 5, 2020 this year, the central government submitted before the Honorable Supreme Court. The central government has filed an affidavit before the Honorable Supreme Court stating that it has approved the policy for granting various reliefs for COVID pandemic, including a policy whereby waiver of interest on interest will be effectuated for eligible borrowers of loan up to rupees 2 crore. The eligible borrowers under the scheme shall be MSME loans, education loans, housing loans, consumer durable loans, credit card dues, automobile loans, personal loans to professionals, and consumption loans of up to rupees 2 crore. To be eligible for the scheme, your account should be standard as on 29th February 2020, and the loan should not be a non-performing asset, that is NPA, as on that date as per the bank prudential norm. Under the scheme, the difference between the compound interest and simple interest will be credited to the borrower's loan account for the period between March 1st 2020 and August 31st 2020. Lending institutions defined under the scheme shall credit the difference in the borrower's account. These lending institutions include banking company, public sector banks, cooperative banks, regional rural banks, All India financial institutions, non-banking financial companies, that is NBFCs, and housing finance company or HFCs. Center has stated that the aforesaid decision has been taken after careful consideration, keeping in mind the overall economic scenario, nature of borrowers, impact on the economy, and such other factors as a policy decision earmarking aforementioned borrowers as a class of borrowers for grant of relief or benefit. The center submitted before the Honorable Supreme Court that, as earlier stated in the affidavit filed on October 9 this year, it is reiterated that depending upon the situation prevailing in the country and globally, and keeping several financial and other factors in mind, each sector will be getting relief as mentioned in the earlier affidavit of the central government and the affidavit of the RBI, including beneficiaries of the present scheme. The lending institution is required to credit the amount to the borrower's account by 5th November 2020. Very important date. My dear friends, be sure that difference between compounded interest and simple interest for the moratorium period shall be credited to your account by 5th November 2020. Good news for all borrowers. This affidavit came after Supreme Court pulled up the central government on October 14 this year for its delay in implementation of its decision for providing benefits to the small borrowers who had taken loan of up to rupees 2 crore. It is submitted that the preparation of the scheme in this behalf was under contemplation, and it was also necessary to formalize the said policy by following certain mandatory procedures required by law. Center explained in its affidavit. A bench comprising Justice Ashok Bhushan, Justice Subhash Reddy, and Justice M. R. Shah told the center that even though it welcomed the decision of relieving the small borrowers, there was no reason to delay the implementation of said decision. Dil Diwali is in your hands, Mr. Mehta, the bench told the Solicitor General. The Solicitor General then informed the bench that there was diversity in lending and different modalities are required to be followed. Consultations are on between the various stakeholders, he added. The bench also added that it has always permitted the government to take as much time as they required so that they could come back with the instructions, but that it was not in the interest of the common man to continue delaying the implementation. Please see the plight of the common man, Justice Amar Shah remarked. Bench then went on to indicate that they will take up the case on November 2nd this year, and that it expected the government to tell the Honorable Supreme Court about the implementation of the aforesaid benefit. The affidavit had been filed by the center government in response to a batch of pleas in the apex court raising issues pertaining to the validity of the RBI's March 27 circular, which allowed lending institutions to grant moratorium on payment of installments of term loans falling due between March 1st and May 31st this year due to the pandemic. Later, the period of the moratorium was extended till 31st of August. In my second video on this issue, I shall be discussing various questions and queries coming to your mind relating to crediting the compound interest charge during moratorium period by various lenders in your account in detail, so that you may understand how you will get the benefit and how much shall be the benefit. Enjoy the waiver. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.